Hi guys, how are you? I have a quick message I want to share. Happy Sunday. So I was talking to God last night and I actually got a bunch of messages for you guys, but he basically wants me to tell you guys to stop trying to prove yourself to people, okay? And I understand I spoke to you guys about explaining yourself and the importance of not explaining yourself because you can end up explaining your prophecies and all of that. Proving yourself is kind of similar to that. Sometimes you don't even have to explain yourself, but sometimes you'll have the mentality of, I'm gonna be successful at this to prove you wrong, or I'm gonna do this to prove you wrong. And you know, God doesn't want us to do that. He's saying, don't prove yourself to anybody, okay? The only thing you have to prove yourself to, the only proof that is needed is proof towards God. Okay, that's it. Because you have to understand that you're working for God. You're not working for man. So even a simple little, you know, I'm gonna do this video, or I'm gonna do this photo shoot or photo, or I'm gonna do this, this whatever God tells me to work on. I'm just talking about things that I usually work on, right? As examples and stuff like that. But let's just say that you're in the medical field, you're a doctor, and you know, God is giving you prophecies on how to treat specific patients because he's showing you specific patients and prophesying over specific patients, and somebody comes in and criticizes you, and then when they criticize you, now you want to sit there and you want to do your job 10 times better, or you want to change the originality of what you're doing before. The originality is what God specifically told you what to do and the instructions he gave you to do. But sometimes you may end up changing the whole originality of what it is God told you to do because you're trying to prove yourself to man. You know, when you change the originality of something, the results can be different, right? You have to, let me give you a scripture that God gave me, okay? So this is Colossians 3, verse 23 to 24. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ you are serving. You see, when you know you are serving God and you are doing something specifically, you know, because God told you to do it, and you're doing something a specific way because God told you to do it, you know, proving yourself to man, you can literally lose the originality of what it is that you were doing. The results can change. Now you are no longer trying to prove yourself to God. Now you are no longer working for God, but you are now trying to prove yourself to man, and it's kind of like you're working for man. Do you get what I'm saying? You don't want to change the originality of what God told you to do to begin with, because I'm telling you, and there's another scripture here, Proverbs 16 verse 2, all a person's ways seem pure to them, but the motives are weighed by the Lord. So this is something we all have to work on, okay? Proving yourself to others, or trying to prove yourself to others, you know, your ways and your ways may seem pure, right? But the motives behind trying to prove yourself to someone can be completely off, and it may not be motives through God. Do you see what I'm saying? Because for instance, had that person not criticized you, had that person had not critiqued you, okay, had that person not put you down, had that person not shamed you, would you have continued to do it the way God told you to do it? Or do you get what I'm saying? Like, had they not done that, you would have continued to do it the way God told you to do it, right? But because they critiqued you, they judged you, they criticized you, now you're changing the ways of you doing it. Now it's no longer pure motives through God. It's now, okay, I'm doing this just to prove a point to you. I'm doing this just to prove you wrong. God will humble your enemies. That's what he told me. He said, I will serve them some humble pie. But when God serves your enemies humble pie, it's not through you trying to prove yourself to them. It's not through you trying to do things because they critiqued you. Do you get what I'm saying? It's you working for God. And then what happens is the inheritance you receive from God, the reward you receive from God, that's going to automatically prove your enemies wrong. That's going to automatically, God is going to automatically serve them the humble pie through that. Let me give you some examples. So I'm going to use my examples, for instance. Okay. There's been people that before, they have put time frames on my head. Okay. They have put hits on my head, time frames from my head on my head. What I mean by time frames is God says it's going to happen to you in this amount of days. God said that's going to happen to you in this amount of days. A lot of people have done that to me. Do you get what I'm saying? And the thing about it is that their motives were not pure. You know what I mean? They were saying this stuff out of evil intentions in their heart. and they were trying to use God as a scapegoat and try to blame God and say, God told them that. And God tells me, I never said that. And God is not two-faced. Let me just tell you that, okay? And God would say, that did not come from me. That was out of their evil intentions in their heart. They already had a hardened heart towards you. And guess what happened? Did I try to prove myself? No. I never tried to go online, defend myself. I never tried to prove myself to nobody. I just continued to do what God was telling me to do. I did not shift my path. I did not change anything. Do you get what I'm saying? Everything that God gave me, the messages that God gave me was through him. It wasn't me, okay, I'm going to put a message out because my hater said this. I'm going to put a message up because my hater said that. No. It was literally when God and me would have conversations, he would give me scriptures that same night. And he would say, use this as a learning example, not just for you, but for the people, for the children. Do you see what I'm saying? And I was still following God's instructions. I never once changed anything, right? And because of that, God was able to serve my enemies humble pie. Do you see what I'm saying? He was able to serve them humble pie. And I noticed, and although I didn't want to know what happened to them, I noticed that every time they put a time frame on me, 3 days, 5 days, 7 days, however amount of days, something bad would end up happening to them in that time frame. Do you see what I'm saying? And that's without me trying to prove myself or nothing. So I'm saying this to say that you don't have to worry about how people feel about you, what they think about you. People are going to critique you in your whole life. Let me tell you something about people. People that have time to critique you, that have time to judge you, do you see what I'm saying? Most of them don't really have a lot of things going for them. Most of them are stuck in their ways and they're stuck where they are right now. The reason why they're stuck where they are right now is because they continue putting focus so much on critiquing other people and judging other people, they fail to look at themselves. They fail to look at themselves because all that energy is being put into people. And because they fail to look into themselves, there's no growth. There's no growth. There's no learning. Do you see what I'm saying? And then they end up staying stuck. And then the more they stay stuck, the more miserable they are. And then they start looking for more people to critique. So it's just a consistent pattern. Do you get what I'm saying? So what God is saying is, I will serve your enemies some humble pie. Do not try to prove yourself to people. Do you get what I'm saying? Even if they're not your enemy and they just try to critique you and you know they're wrong, God says, don't try to prove yourself. Don't do anything with the intentions of, I'm going to do this to prove them wrong. I'm going to do that to prove them wrong. Because I'm telling you, the way your God may have to not humble you, because your ways may go from being pure, maybe going from the instructions that God gave you to all of a sudden shifting your instructions because you're trying to prove yourself to man. Do you see what I'm saying? Shifting your instructions because you're trying to prove your enemies wrong. Okay, so God is saying, don't prove yourself to people, and remember this for that for this year. Just continue staying on the path that God has placed you on and continue to follow God's instructions. Okay, is that it? That's it. I wrote everything down. You gave me this morning. Anyways, I love you guys. I'll talk to you soon. Okay, bye.